Okay, students, today we are going to study very most important topic of the 17th group. Okay, this topic is going to give you at least one objective. If there is a question from this group, definitely it is going to be related to this group. Okay, the topic is none other than interhalogen compound. What is the topic? Interhalogen compound. Okay. So as you all know, in chemistry 90% of the things 90% of the things are conveyed to you 90% of the things are conveyed to you through the name itself. Okay, if you understand proper English behind it, then 90% of the things you can expect at least. Okay, so inter, between, halogen, two halogen, the compound formed by two halogens is called as a interhalogen compounds. Okay, now questions are conceptual questions. Okay, there are certain questions which you have to remember that I am not going to cover. Okay, already notes is with you, and notes you can find it anywhere, any book you can read out. But making a logical reasoning, making a conceptual question, okay, the difference between other exams and this exam, competitive exams, lies in the how you think innovatively. If there is, says, 135 boiling point, 135 degrees, so if you read that 135 degree, then you are successful in board exam. But if 135 degree is there, then what is the effect it is going to have, what effect it is going to have, and what are the consequences, why it is 135, why not something else? In that logical reasoning, in that logical reasoning way, if you understand, then it will be easy for you, then it will be easy for you to attempt the competitive exams. So your preparation should be entirely different. For preparing the competitive point of view, your thinking should be innovative. Okay, so if I say oxidation number is this, so you should think and analyze, why not this, why only this one only? Okay, so accordingly you have to manage, accordingly you have to manage. Okay, now interhalogen compound, so between two halogen, a halogen compound formed by two halogens is called as a interhalogen compounds. Okay, so in books, in some books it is mentioned as xx dash. So but students reported that there is a problem in understanding if x dash is some places misprint is there. So to avoid that misprintage and to avoid that inconvenience, what I am doing, I am doing it as a and x. Here both are halogen only, a also halogen and x is also halogen, both are halogen only. Only for your convenience, what I am making a also a and x, instead of taking x x dash, some books printed as x x dash. So if x dash is not visible, then there will be a confusion. So to avoid that, clearly I am mentioning it as a and x. Okay, so I will give you a tabular form. Okay, tabular form in the starting itself, so that what we are going to study, you should have a clear idea. Okay, interhalogen compounds is compounds formed between, compounds formed by two halogens. They may be of the same or they may be of the different. Okay, halogens may be same or halogen may be different also. Okay, so if same halogen, then it is already dihalides. Okay, that is not much important. But if the compound word I am using, that means there should be two different elements, compound and elemental state, that is the difference. If every element of this molecule is same, then it is called elementary molecule. If it is different, then it is a compound molecule. Okay, now I am dividing this entire topic into few types. Okay, so few types will be AX, second will be AX3, third will be AX5, and fourth will be AX7. Okay, so these are the compounds which are AX, AX3, AX5 and AX7. These categories we are going to study. Okay, and in most of the notes there will be examples for them. Okay, so but logical questions I am going to give you here. Examples I am writing. Okay, CLF, for the examples of AX, CLF, BRF, BRCL, ICL and IBR. Okay, these are the interhalogen compounds. These are the interhalogen compounds examples, which are examples of AX type. Which type? AX type. Okay. Maximum you will find in AX type only. No problem. And keep on decreases. Why it decreases number of example? That also I will give you reason. Okay. Reasoning questions are important. And some questions are there which are you can read and memorize. Okay. If there any trick to remember, then also I will mention. Otherwise, it is your duty to read and memorize. Okay. BRF3. Okay. Then most important here is ICL3. ICL3 twice. In this one, most important is this one. Okay. And next coming to the AX5. In AX5, number of examples will keep on decreases. Why it will keep on decreases, I will tell you. Okay. And you can also understand. Some smart students are there. They themselves understand. Okay. IF5. And here only example IF7. Okay. See, there is a decrease in number of examples. That means where there is a reason behind it. There is a trend followed. Okay. Why it is trend followed? So when you go through this, you should have too few doubts. What is that? Why only odd numbers? Okay. First doubt is why only odd numbers? Why not even numbers? Why not AX4? Why not AX6? Why not AX8? Okay. And why not AX2? Why they are not existing? Okay. And what is the logic behind why this fluorine cannot come here? Okay. So these are the examples which you will come to know in the future class. So try to be connected with me. Try to be connected with me and very good. Some student reason gave the reason also. Okay. That is what it motivates me. And that is the advantage of being present in the class. Okay. If you are present in the all lecture, if you have seen all lectures and made proper notes, then it is going to reflect in your future groups also. Okay. So like in my previous lecture, I mentioned plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 7. There only I mentioned the reason also. That is going to be used over here. Okay. So these are the some examples. Okay. Now criteria for selecting A and criteria for selecting X. Okay. Who, what element is eligible to be A and what element is eligible for X? For selecting A and X, there are some eligibility condition. Okay. Criteria of A and X. Okay. So normally in future lecture, I am going to use A as a central element, otherwise master element. Better word will be master element. Okay. Central element, I am taking it as a master element. And this I will call it as slave element. What I will call it as? Slave element. Okay. So this terminology, they may not be using in the exam. This terminology they may not be using in the exam, but for my convenience, for easy to understand, I am using this. Okay. A is master element which is going to lie at the center, and X is the slave element which is going to connected with the master element. Okay. So master element, it should be able to accommodate many number of X or not. So to accommodate many number of X, the very first condition, the size should be large enough. Okay. Large atom, you should select it as a very good. Large element must be selected as a master element. Okay. If you got two elements, like suppose chlorine and bromine. Bromine is bigger. So this will be master and this will be slave. Okay. Master and slave. Size you can understand. Otherwise, there is another criteria also. If the slave element will be able to form or excite electron to the higher state, that is possible only when ionization energy is less, our electronegativity is less. Okay, so less electronegative element will be taken as master element. Okay, so electronegativity should be low and size should be more for master element out of the given pair of element for selecting master element. Just opposite criteria will be for the slave element. Okay, so size should be small and the second is electronegativity should be high. Is it understood? So now the question comes, why fluorine can never be master element? Okay, why fluorine can never be master element? How many reasons you can tell? Okay. So why fluorine cannot be master element is absence of d orbital. Okay, absence of d orbital. Why it is going to make a difference is, let us take 2s2 2p5. So if it wanted to form master element, at least how many bonds it should be able to form? 3 bonds it should be able to form or not? So for that, 3 unpaired is must. So there is no d orbital, so it cannot form more than one bond. Okay, for a element to be master element, it should be able to excite the electron to improve its covalency beyond one. But such facility is not there in fluorine, attributed to its absence of 2d orbital. Okay, is it understood? Okay, very nice reply by one of the students. Okay, then after fluorine, then what about iodine? Fluorine can't be master element. Okay, but iodine can't be. Very nice. Iodine can't be slave element. Okay, so iodine can't be slave element. What is the reason? Very nice. Now here it is size. Okay, suppose if you see chlorine is at the center and for at least 3 iodine are there. So if 3 iodine are there, can it be able to accommodate around it? Very good. At small atomic size and higher atomic size. Okay, because of the higher atomic size, it cannot accommodate around the small atom. So being a big element, it can accommodate many elements around it. So iodine is not suitable for slave element, whereas fluorine is not suitable for master element. Okay, that is the reason. Is it understood, students? And I am telling you mainly for the criteria of AX3 and above. Suppose AX, we can't say who is master and who is slave, because both are just side by side. There is no much problem in the AX type. Some students in the live are asking, sir, in AX what is this condition? Okay, in AX there is no problem because both are equally important. Both are forming same number of bonds. There is no around atom, there is no central atom. Okay, so for AX3 and above, this rule of applicable. Okay, now let us take the why not AX4. So it will be NS2 NP5 ND0. Okay, so when it electron enters here, 3 unpaired. When electron enters here, 5, presently 1 unpaired. When electron goes here, 5 unpaired. Okay, so then next stage it is going to be 7 unpaired. So there is no possibility of 4 unpaired. There is no possibility of 6 unpaired. There is no possibility of 2 unpaired. That's why interhalogen molecules cannot be formed with even number. And some students asking, some examples, but they are not in the monomeric form. They are in the dimeric form or they are in the ionic form. Which form? Ionic form. Okay. So in the interhalogen compounds only AX, AX3, AX5, AX7, only four criteria. Is it understood? In them, what is the most important? I told you ICl3. Why it is important, that I am going to cover it. Okay. So let us take one by one. Let us take one by one AX structure. Okay. First, let us cover about the structure. Structure AX. AX is simply linear. Okay. Why? Because only two elements are there. Wherever you keep it, there will be, wherever you keep it, there will be straight line only. You keep A and X here straight line. You keep A and X here straight line. Okay. So there is no problem of the AX linear. Okay. There is no problem of the hybridization also. Hybridization is required when one element forms more than one type of bond. Okay. So, but some books and some people are saying like AX hybridization, 3 lone pair, 1 bond pair. Only one bond is there, for hybridization is not required. The very purpose of hybridization is to, if two bonds are there, they both should be of the same type, length should be same, energy same, then only hybridization takes place. Okay. Now coming to the AX3 type. Now the main problem starts and you have to make a note of it. AX3, here central element N value. Let us take it as NS2, NP5. So at this condition, we'll be able to form hybridization and directly accommodate three elements. No, it cannot accommodate three elements because it contains only one unpaired. To accommodate three elements, it should provide three unpaired electrons. For that, what it will make use of? ND it will make use of. And only required number of electrons to be excited. It is not that all electron you will keep on exciting. Every time ask yourself, is it sufficient or not? Suppose if I excite this, how many unpaired I am going to get? 3. 1, 2, and this will also become unpaired. When it goes there, that is also unpaired. And earlier, this is also unpaired. So 3 unpaired electrons already sufficient. This number of unpaired should be equal to this. Then you stop exciting. Okay. Then you should stop exciting. Then resulting configuration will be NS2, NP5 will become as a NP4 and ND will become as 1. Okay. So NS2, NP4, NP4. And now it is able to provide 4 unpaired, 3 unpaired. So 3 unpaired and hybridization. So hybridization is going to be sp3d hybridization. What is the hybridization? sp3d hybridization with these two are lone pair, 2 lone pair, 3 bond pair, 2 lone pair and 3 bond pair. Now here problem comes, where to keep lone pair, where to keep bond pairs. Where to keep lone pair, where to keep bond pairs, there is a rule for it. Okay, there is a rule to accommodate lone pair and bond pair, especially in sp3 hybridization. Okay, so that special video is there, then you can go through it. Otherwise, I will explain here only. Okay, so to avoid any complication, I will explain here only along with the reason. So now presently we are with the sp3d hybridization, 2 lone pair. So as per the sp3 hybridization, central element, that is master element, is at center, and we got 3 places in a plane, triangular plane. 3 places in triangular plane and 1 place above, 1 place below. So we got how many places to accommodate a lone pair and bond pair? We got 3 places in the triangle, 1 place above, and so normally 3 bond pair and 2 lone pair. So what will be the general tendency? Two lone pair are there, why not to keep it over here? And three bond pairs, X, X, and X. It should be kept like this or not? So it is very beautiful, triangular planar, but it is not like that. Okay, you should not see only beautiness, you should also see some stability also. Okay, so this is beautiful but not stable. What is matters? Stability matters. If you are stable, then beauty will come on its own. So three bond pairs, two lone pair, it should be triangular planar. No, it is not correct. These should be accommodated. Lone pairs are dangerous persons. Lone pairs are dangerous persons. They are to be accommodated far away from each other. Okay, this is the far away from each other. When they are placed far away from each other, also from halogens, also from other halogens. Okay, so this is their best place to accommodate, because here they are getting how much? 120 degree. Separation is how much? 120 degree. So there will be repulsion will be minimum, stability will be maximum. Repulsion will be what? Minimum, and stability will be maximum when I place this lone pair over here. And repulsion also will be less in terms of the bond pair. Okay, by keeping the lone pair at the triangular vertices, I am minimizing lone pair repulsion. Also, I am minimizing lone pair bond pair repulsion. That's why lone pair must be accommodated at the vertices of a equilateral triangle, and it results in, so once they are lone pair, you need not to consider them for the shape. So it appears to be which shape? T shape. It appears to be which shape? T shape. Okay, so what is the answer for AX3? Answer for AX3 hybridization is sp3d hybridization. Hybridization is what? Sp3d hybridization. Three bond pair, two lone pair, and electronic structure is triangular bipyramidal, and actual structure is T shape. Actual structure is T shape. Already I have given you examples also. Already I have given you examples also. And some doubt are there. Will it be able to maintain 180 degree or not? No, this 180 degree is not maintained, because you think of it. Here, this repulsion is how much? Bond pair repulsion are not, and this repulsions are lone pair bond pair. Actually, to be frankly speaking, it is not a perfect T. It will be a T like this. Slight bent will be there, because this side repulsion forces are more. It will be like arrow. Okay, but only for your convenience, they teach it as a T shape. Okay, AX3 wise completed. Now come, let us come back to the AX5. What is the next one? AX5. In AX5, I have to provide five unpaired electron. Okay, how many unpaired electron? Five unpaired electron. In the previous example, see here, A is there, and this is X, this is X, this is X. So there is a lone pair here, there is a lone pair here. So because of this repulsion, they will move like this, and this repulsion, it will move like this. So this repulsions are which repulsion? Bond pair repulsion. What repulsion? Bond pair repulsion. Okay, so but here repulsions are lone pair repulsion. This repulsion dominates bond pair repulsion. So because of this, this perpendicularity is not maintained properly. It will be 89, 88. That depends on this element size also. But proper 180 degree perpend, sorry, 90 degree is not maintained. Okay, is it understood? Okay. Next, coming to AX5. In AX5, I have to provide how many? Five bond pair I have to provide. Where from I am ensuring? From here I am coming to know that five unpaired must be mentioned. So NS2, NP5, ND. NS2NP5ND. So I told you, you should keep on asking yourself also. Like if after transferring 3 unpaired, is it sufficient? No. Then you should go for the second excited state. Now NS2NP, out of 5, 3 electrons, 2 electrons are transferred. So 3 electron will be left over and ND2. So NS2NP3 and ND2. Okay, so hybridization must be what? sp3d2 hybridization is there. And how many lone pair? Five bond pair and one lone pair. Okay, so one lone pair and five bond pair. Now how to decide the structure? Deciding structure is depending on the keeping the hybridization, then allotting the lone pair at the proper position. Our hybridization is what? sp3d2. According to that hybridization, what it must be? Square bipyramidal. This is A. So four bonds can be accommodated at the vertices, of a corner of square, and two can be accommodated at any place. Now here, see, here also bond angle 90, here also bond angle 90. Now if everywhere bond angle is same, now you can look after the butyness. Previously, in the previous example, there was no option of the butyness, because more preference is given to the stability. Here everywhere same stability, because everywhere bond angle is 90 degree. So I got 5x and one lone pair. Now it is up to you where you want it to keep. Suppose if you want to keep x here, then lone pair will be placed over here. Earlier its name used to be square bipyramid, but this is not there. So the shape is going to be square pyramidal. Shape is going to be what? Square pyramidal. Okay. So sp3d2, ax5. What is the answer for ax5? sp3d2 hybridization, one lone pair, five bond pair, and a square bipyramid. Square pyramidal is actual shape. Is it understood? Now we are entering into the last example, that is ax7. What is the last example? AX7 is the last example. Okay. So in the AX7, seven unpaired is to be provided. That means all electron from the SPD all should be given to excited state. NS2, NP5, ND0. This is a ground state. So number of electron to be excited depends, decided by the number of slave atoms. Okay, so here as of now I have only one unpaired, now three unpaired, now five unpaired, but I require seven unpaired, so this will also go there. So because of this, what happening? Because of this, there is no chance of the lone pair at all. So NS1, NP5 and ND, how many they are getting? 3. So hybridization will be simple and geometry also very, very simple. NP3. Okay. Geometry is very simple. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So hybridization will be sp3d3. What is the hybridization? sp3d3. sp3d3 hybridization. Okay, so there is no lone pair, so no problem of accommodating. If lone pair is there, then only you have to think where to keep lone pair, where to keep bond pair. But there is no lone pair, sp3d3 hybridization should be, structure should be pentagonal bipyramidal. What should be the highest structure? Pentagonal bipyramidal. So this is the pentagon and this is the bipyramid. Okay, pentagonal bipyramidal IF7. IF7. So this is the shape of the IF7 pentagon bipyramidal. Again here, lone pair and bond pair angles, if they are there, then there is a problem. Here the angle is different, here angle is different. If you have a chance to, IF7 example I told you, if it is AX5, this will be A and X will be fluorine. Okay, so this is all about the structures of, interhalogen compounds. These are the interhalogen compounds. Okay, now we will study some important properties. We are going to study very important compound when the examination point of view is ClF3. What is the important compound? ClF3. It is hypergolic. What is the speciality in it is hypergolic. What is it normally in pictures? You will see every explosive requires some initiation, like it should be heated, it should be pressed, or some pin is to be taken out. Hypergolic is a special kind of explosive. Hypergolic is a special type of explosive which does not need any initiation. So this was successfully used in the Second World War. It is successfully used in Second World War and it is a poisonous gas. ClF3 is hypergolic. What is hypergolic? Hypergolic is a compound or an explosive which does not require any initiation. Is it understood, students? Now there is a most important question. This is first important objective. Second important objective is why interhalogen compounds. Important objective I am telling you. Okay. Compounds are more reactive than dihalides. Okay, what is the question? Interhalogen compounds are more reactive than dihalide, like Cl2 ICl. Which is more reactive? ICl is more reactive. What is the reason? Anybody can guess why ICl is more reactive than Cl2? Any guesswork? First, ClF3 hypergolic and its reason and its importance already I told you. Interhalogen compound. Let us take I and Cl. So both elements connected together, they are not equally. Okay, ionic bond is not a reason. Very nice. Difference in electronegativity. What is the reason? Difference in electronegativity. Okay. So this is partial negative, this is partial positive. So charge is there, that ionic nature will be introduced, polar molecule. Whereas if it is, suppose Cl2. Okay. So Cl2 both are non-polar. Okay. So there is no charge, so less reactivity. So difference in answer should be polarity. What should be the answer? Polarity. Difference in electronegativity creates polarity. Difference in electronegativity, what it makes? Creates polarity. Partial positive, partial negative. Then attraction will be there. Attraction will improve its reactivity. Okay. Sometimes the question may be why ICl is a solid. Okay. Like question one. This is one previous question only I am telling you. The reason behind reactivity of interhalogen compounds corresponding to halogens are due to polarity. Sometimes they may give in the terms of the bond energy also. Like it is difficult to break this bond. It is large, a small bond and it is large bond. Okay. Now question, next question. Next question is, Okay, question will be there. ICL is a lemon yellow solid. What is the question? ICL is a lemon yellow solid, but bromine is a brown liquid. What is the reason? What is the reason? Okay, again, the answer should be in terms of the intermolecular forces. Always remember, whenever there is a question regarding the physical state, you should write the answer in terms of the molecular forces, intermolecular forces. Stronger the intermolecular forces, stronger will be and tendency to stay in the solid is more. In ICL, what happens? This color also, okay? So in ICL, there will be partial positive here, partial negative here. Now the next molecule will be like this, Cli. So this will be positive, this will be negative, and this will be positive. So attraction force is strong enough. This is one dipole, this is another dipole. This is one dipole, this is another dipole. But here, no dipole, no dipole. Br2 and Br2. There is no charges, so there is no attraction. Okay? There is no charge, so there is no attraction in case of the Br2. In Br2, non-polar, weak van der Waals forces. In Cli, polar molecule, dipole-dipole attraction. So due to strong intermolecular force of attraction, what happens? It exists as a solid. Due to weak intermolecular force of attraction, it exists as a liquid. And color nature is also because of the excitation of electron. Because of the excitation of electron. Okay? So this is the third important question. These are all important questions. Okay. So why ICl3 exists in dimer state and what is its structure? Why ICl3 exists in dimer state and what is its structure? It is isostructural to AlCl3. What it is? It is isostructural to what? AlCl3. Okay. In a like AlCl3, central atom is aluminium. Here central atom is what? Al. Okay. So one chlorine here, another chlorine here, third chlorine here. This is one molecule of AlCl3. Sorry, ICl3. Okay. And another molecule of ICl3 is like this. This is another molecule. Now, this will donate lone pair to this. This will donate lone pair to this. This is a structure of ICl3 twice. Okay. Why ICl3 exists as a dimer? Because of its large atomic size. Because of its large atomic size, I can accommodate more number of chlorine around it than the other. Okay. So, question may be like, ClF3 exists, but not FCl3. Like this examples you can write or not. What you will write? A bigger chlorine can excite electron to accommodate three electron with three bonds. But fluorine cannot excite due to absence of d orbital. Okay? Like same example. One most important question is, which halogen forms? Question, listen carefully. Which halogen forms maximum number of interhalogen compounds? Interhalogen compounds. What is the answer? Which halogen forms maximum number of interhalogen compounds? Which halogen forms maximum number of interhalogen compound? Okay. See the question. Which halogen forms maximum number of interhalogen compounds? Second question, which halogen forms interhalogen compound with maximum halogens? Okay, here this answer is iodine. because iodine can accommodate 7 fluorine around it. Maximum halogens are there here. But question is not here same. Here, fluorine can be with any element. That's why for this answer, fluorine. Fluorine is found in the most of the intrahalogen compound. First answer is fluorine, second answer is iodine. See how similar question is. So if you are not attentive, if you are not aware of this fact, then it is very difficult to attempt examination question. That's why reading from the book and getting guidance from a good teacher is matters. How the questions are framed and how you should be in the trap of the examiner. That only you will learn here. Is it understood? Okay. See you. Bye-bye.